Time probably came at a good time for Paul McLean and his team. And
here's Danny Briere with a shot. He scores! Seconds in, the Canadians get the start they wanted. Daniel Briere, 1-0 Montreal.
Jim, the Sens have been getting up some face-off draws in the defensive zone that have cost them here. They won the draw cleanly, but it was a heads-up play by Briere. Watch, the draw was won by Turris, but inside position by Briere, and this is one for Robert Leonard, but he just didn't find it through the legs immediately. Look at Gionta, ties up with the defenseman, and it sticks side. And as Elliot mentioned in the pregame for Leonard, 6 goals against the Detroit Red Wings, knocked out of that game, and what an inauspicious start for him here. Time probably came.
Start to the game. Kyle Turris with a little tip. Clark MacArthur, Bobby Ryan, Carlson joins the rush. Now he leads it. He passed into some feet. Spezza shoots. He scores. Jason Spezza joined the rush right off the bench. And a pass that wasn't even intended for him came right to his stick, and it's a 1-1 game.
Well, after an epic battle in the defensive zone by the Senators in front, this is a change. And watch number 19 come off the bench. And this is just a pass that wasn't even intended for him. And right down the slot with traffic in front, no chance at all for Carey Price. This is the first shot on goal against Price, and it's walking in for Jason Spezza, who now is on a 3-game scoring streak. That pass to Clark MacArthur went off his stick and found its way right onto the stick of Spezza coming off the bench.
What did the Senators ever need that? Start to the game. Up to center. Neal got there before Gallagher. Doug Murray stepped up, and now he's down on the ice and out of the play. Colin Greening to the net. Stopped by Price. There'll be a penalty on the play, and the puck's in the net. They're going to call a penalty, maybe even a penalty shot, but Greening's momentum into the goaltender Carey Price knocked the puck into the net, and Ottawa appears to have the lead.
Now the discussion here between the officials is obviously you can't knock a goaltender into the net and have the puck go in with it, but I think the puck came out and Neal actually put it in, which is why the reaction happened right off the way. We'll be the judge here. Another dreaded turnover. Murray loses it to Greening. Greening coming in. Here's the penalty right there, but watch the puck go right there off of Neal. That's why the call on the ice by the official, at least there. Now they're still discussing it.
But look where the goaltender is.
And is the net already off? You be the judge right there. Oh, he didn't even touch it, and I think the net was coming off. I don't think this one's going to last. We get a better chance there.
Net off can be reviewed.
Ooh, boy.
It was coming off its moorings. Was
very,
it actually
very
off?
Very close, isn't it? And it was still on that right side. I thought it was off on the left side. But the discussion, if we can get the officials on the ice, they're still huddling before they even make the call to Toronto to say what the call is on.
To center.
And there's still more discussion. I don't think it's a goal.
And there's going to be a faceoff in the corner. He's going to tell us officially that it's no goal.
And so obviously, penalty shot wasn't the call.
Penalty has been called on Montreal number 81 for tripping. The puck entered the net after the post get on the mooring. Therefore, there's no goal in the play.
Hockey ops saves referees.
Yep, I think it's the right. And the break there for Ottawa. You had 4 forwards and Carlson, who's now on about a 2-minute and 10-second shift.
Here's Zach Smith, breaks in, stopped by Price, scores on the rebound. A hang with him for Zach Smith, and he makes it 2-1 just after the power play failed.
And old iron lungs Carlson again makes just a heck of a heads-up pass and springs Smith in. Watch, everybody's dead tired making a change and a long saucer pass, tape to tape, that Price gets a piece of but can't find the rebound, and it slips by in a heads-up play. But Erik Karlsson, this is a 2-minute and 10-second shift that ends with this goal. Look at the reaction of Price. He gambled early and he reacted, got a little bit off balance and couldn't control the rebound. Break there for Ottawa.
King zone, but not for long. Here comes Milan McCulloch. Spezza's coming up behind him. A good defensive play by P.K. Subban. There's Spezza, got a loose puck centering. Hemsky scores! Yastrzemski with his first goal as an Ottawa Senator, and it's a 3-1 Ottawa lead, and puck is quickly collected by Milan Mikolic.
Well, that look on the face of Michel Therrien says it all, and this is just attack. Again, a pinch in the offensive zone creates an odd man rush, but watch the effort of Mikolic. Loose puck, he wins the battle over Galchenyuk. Puck goes by Subban, and just a little bit too far and too late. A no-look pass by Spezza on the tape of Hemsky, and that's a perfectly placed shot. You could see Price thought he was going glove side, was ready to get the glove out there, and instead Hemsky goes back the other way and beats him.
King zone, but not for. Chris Phillips flushed out by Alex Galchenyuk. Kyle Turris to center, Clark MacArthur with a shoot in. Bobby Ryan's after it. Gambling is back. Turris centering, MacArthur scores! Bobby Ryan took the hit and made the play. Turris set up Clark MacArthur, and this line that's been golden all season makes it 4-1.
And that's been the common theme. The Senators are just winning those puck battles. They get in quickly. Gamelin takes a long route instead of going right after the puck. He's a little late getting there. And all Ryan does is make sure it continues on. And how about the pass by Turris? And the nightmare evening for Carey Price continues. These three of the four goals have been all like this. Quick plays from one in the slot, a one-timer by Jason Spezza, and then those last two goals eerily similar, aren't they? Losing the battle from behind and a wide-open Ottawa Senator. And
gave it back to Mikolic. Hemsky to the blue line in the thought. On the other side, Carlson. Another great battle going on in front of the net. Mikolic and thrust, and now the gloves are off and they're swinging.
Look at Mathot coming in to protect Mikolic, who's not a big fighter. Oh, I thought he hit his head on the ice too.
Yeah, Brandon Prust is a scrapper. Mikolic is not, but he'd had enough in this battle in front of the net.
And for so long in this game, Jim, it's been left go, and those battles haven't led to much more. This time, it was actually Mikolic who initiated a little bit more than Prust.
Gave it back to Mikolic.
Style in this game, has he? But he's been effective anyway.
Ryan Gianta off the wing with a shot. There's a rebound. Score! Finally, Lars Eller. No big celebration, but 24-game goalless slump has finally come to an end for Lars Eller.
And I tell you, this game is far from over. And you think of that Briere one that hit the goalpost. Leonard, as I mentioned, it hasn't been pretty all night, and this is another one you just got to have. He wasn't able to control the rebound, tried to squeeze under his arm, and this is another good example of stopping on the net. You know, you go so long without scoring goals, your confidence level is low, but that's one fundamentals. Get to the net, stop on it, then he puts the rebound home. Style in this game has.
Yanda threw the puck at the net. He's seen what's happened there before, and again, they couldn't hold on to it. Swing and a miss by Galchenyuk in front of the net. Subban to the front of the goal, they score. A tip-in. Brian Gianta. It's a one-goal game with a couple minutes to go.
Well, cue the comeback, and this is all on Robin Leonard again. This is one you got to have. He doesn't even know where the puck is. He had a chance to smother it and get a whistle. Now he's down on his knees. Look at the panic in the front of the net. And that quick shot, Gianta with an excellent deflection. The arms go up for Leonard, but this is all on him early on. Not able to control the puck. Running around in the defensive zone. Down too early and up and over his shoulder. Well, what a game.
Gianta from Subban. And it's a one-goal game with 2 minutes and 4 seconds to. Gianta threw the puck at the. Subban again passes off. Bannick shoots rim of the save. Rebound. Lee Sack-Smith gets it. Hard around. Subban holds it in with 20 to go. PK passes off. Thomas Bannick walks in. Pushed down by Colin Greening. Puck goes loose. Diving for it is Greening. Swept back to Subban. Running out of time. Shoots rim of the save. Rebound loose to the boards. One last chance. PK Subban passes off. There and he scores.
I think this is over. The green light is on. The red light is not.
Green light came on, no red light, but we'll have to look at the clock.
How many chances do you have to get that puck out?
This will have to be reviewed with the time code in it, but David Desharnais got the puck to the back of the net on the ice, as you pointed out. The green light came on, meaning period over, so the red light can't come on when the green light is on, but we'll still have to review this.
Instead of shooting the puck, PK Subban makes a laser beam pass over to Desharnais, who somehow grabs it. A chance to clear there. Leonard down, gets knocked by Vanek, and he wasn't happy with that. Gets back up, and watch his reaction going backwards. That's a goal.
That's a goal.
We got ourselves a tie game. Unbelievable. With all the goaltender interference calls you've had, look at the reaction of Leonard. At the end, he's facing the wrong way as this goes up and over Greiba and into the back of the net.
Not much time to spare. 0.3 seconds. And they've just shown it on the big scoreboard in Montreal. What a game.
You saw the reaction of Leonard here. Here's why. Watch Vanek, number 20, comes right across, gets hit. That's probably why no call by Smith. So all of a sudden, Leonard is not settled. He's not back in his net. He saw, track the puck across, and here's the Montreal reaction to David Desharnais tying this hockey game. What a game.
Just the fact that they've got a point at least out of this is miraculous.
And look at the Ottawa bench. If you come back and you say what a mix of emotions this has been. They get scored on 38 seconds into this game. And that puts them on their heels. They battle back. A 4-1 lead turns into a tie. And with 0.3 seconds left, they now have to go to overtime after a ceremonial drop.
Pianta. Frankie Bouillon, drop pass for David Desharnais. Weaves into the attacking zone. Pacioretty off the bench to join him. Bouillon coming up. The puck goes to the net. Leonard stopped it. Is it loose? Pacioretty. There's a loose puck. Bouillon scores! Careful, Bobby Ryan's after the referee. Bouillon put the puck in the net.
And Leonard's losing his mind. But Jim, another incident where it's in his pad, but he doesn't know where it is. He makes no attempt to get his glove down on it. He thinks he has it.
Now they can't review a play that should have been stopped, but one of the referees could say, I was about to blow the whistle and stop the play.
They will confer, but I don't think that's going to happen.
No.
And the Ottawa Senators are just equally as angry as they are stunned.
Frankie Bouillon got the loose puck and put it in behind Robin Leonard, who thought he had the puck frozen. It was Desharnais that dislodged it.
The one thing I will say is Eric Furlatt was right on the doorstep. He was in a position where he could see the puck. Once again, rebound control, real problem for Leonard. He thinks he has it. He doesn't make any attempt to get his glove down on it, but it is open on his pad. And credit the Canadians for not stopping. The frustration for the Senators is so often you get a quick whistle here and the play's dead. As you can see it tight, the puck is loose, it gets jammed away and knocked back. And Bouillon on the doorstep.
And how about a capper for a wild game? Frankie Bouillon gets his first goal in 62 games.
And Cody Ceci, you see number 5 there, tried to clear the puck as he was falling, and he cleared it right onto the stick of Bouillon. I agree, though, so often, Jim, that whistle is blown, or the intent to blow is there. The puck wasn't under his glove, it was sitting on his pad, and the argument begins, but to no avail for the Senators. What a crazy ending to this game.
Well, it was a crazy start and a fitting crazy ending. Bouillon's first goal in a year. And the Montreal Canadiens get 2 points out of a game they looked finished in at 4-1 with 5 minutes to go in the third period.